Hi, everybody. My name is Marissa, and I have a bachelor's degree in mathematics with a minor in statistics. In today's lesson, I will discuss prediction in confidence intervals for regression models. When we compute a regression equation, we are able to simply plug in our value of x in order to find our predicted value of y. Let's say that we have a regression model for how much money one should expect to earn based on years of education after high school, given that y hat equals 23,769 plus 8,702x. If a person has 4 additional years of education, they should expect to earn $58,577. This value was obtained by plugging 4 for x in for our equation. However, what if we want to know a range of incomes that someone with 4 additional years of education should have? What if we want to know what the average income for all people with 4 additional years of education is? There are ways to find a range of potential y values that a particular value of x can be, as well as estimate the mean value of y for all observations that have a particular value of x. We accomplish these goals by using prediction intervals and confidence intervals. The difference between confidence intervals and prediction intervals is that prediction intervals give us a range of values that y can be for a particular x value, but confidence intervals give us a range of values for the mean y for every observation in the population that has a specific x value. Let's say that Lucy is an 18-year-old girl who is considering whether or not to attend a 4-year college or a 2-year college based on our regression model. She wants to know a range of values for the income that a randomly selected person with a 2-year degree will have versus a randomly selected person with a 4-year degree. The formula y hat plus or minus t star times the square root of the sample standard deviation squared plus the standard error of y hat squared gives our prediction interval. Note that the formula for the standard error of y hat is the sample standard deviation times the square root of 1 over n plus x sub j minus x bar squared over the sum of x sub I minus x bar squared. Because this formula is cumbersome, we will use Minitab's prediction interval feature. However, a different statistical software of choice can be used as well if it has a prediction interval feature. We begin the process of finding a prediction interval using Minitab by entering our data. We do this by entering the name of our variables in the columns and entering our values in the rows. We then go to the stat option on the ribbon. Next, we will select regression and then fit regression model. We will put income in the responses box by double-clicking it, and then we will put years of education in the continuous predictors box and select OK. After clicking the OK button, a regression equation will appear above our data. Next, we will select Stat on the ribbon, then Regression, and then Predict. We then choose income as our response variable and enter the values 4 and 2 as the values for years of education. We now click the OK button. Minitab gives us an output for both our prediction and confidence intervals for the x values 2 and 4. The 95% prediction interval shows us that if we randomly select someone with 2 years of education past high school, we can expect with 95% confidence that they earn between $1,025.43 and $81,321.70. For someone with 4 years of education past high school, we can expect with 95% confidence that they earn between $20,632 and $96,525. What if Lucy wanted to find an interval for the mean salary of everyone with a 2-year degree versus everyone with a 4-year degree? This is when we would use a confidence interval. The formula for a confidence interval for the mean y at a specified x is y hat plus or minus t star times the standard error of y hat. However, we will use Minitab for this calculation as well. According to our Minitab output, we can be 95% confident that the mean salary of everyone with a 2-year degree is between $23,520.50 and $58,826.60. For everyone with a 4-year degree, we can be 95% confident that their mean salary is between $46,759.20 and $70,397.80. Now that we have learned about prediction and confidence intervals, let's test our knowledge with a quick exercise. Joshua and Melissa are planning a wedding. In order to cut down on costs, they are considering slimming down their guest list from 100 people to 50 people. They want to know a range of values for the average cost of a wedding with 50 people versus 100 people using the X values 55, 35, 78, 110, and 43, and the Y values 15,000, 12,000, 16,000, 23,000, and 11,000, taken from previous weddings, in order to see if cutting the guest list is worth it. Would Joshua and Melissa use a confidence interval or prediction interval? Using the chosen interval, interpret the results. Use a 95% interval. Because Joshua and Melissa want to know the average cost of all weddings with 50 and 100 people, they should use a confidence interval. According to the Minitab output, they can be 95% confident that a wedding with 50 people will cost between $10,973.20 and $15,556.10, and a wedding with 100 people will cost between $17,421.10 and $24,145.80. Great job, everyone! Today we learned about prediction intervals for regression models. We also learned about confidence intervals for regression models. Thanks for watching, and please be sure to check out other videos about statistics lessons and applications here on Chegg. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.